The FBI has raided the headquarters of one of the nation's largest operators of psychiatric hospitals.
Hundreds complained of overbilling, misdiagnosed conditions, and insurance fraud.
Investigators say they found more than 5,000 similar cases in all 50 states.
Psychiatrists clearly are getting rich.
Psychiatrists traded drugs for sex, filed false insurance claims, and exploited patients sexually.
We have uncovered some of the most elaborate, aggressive, creative, deceptive, immoral, and illegal schemes being used to fill empty hospital beds with insured and paying patients.
Каждый психиатр дает клятву следовать этическим нормам поведения и ставить заботу о пациентах превыше всего. Но из всех отраслей медицины именно психиатрия славится мошенничеством и злоупотреблениями.
Psychiatry is almost a license to print money. If a doctor were clever enough, and many of them are, there's no reason that they couldn't make at least $500,000 a year fraudulently and get away with it in psychiatry.
I don't purport to have deposed every psychiatrist in Las Vegas. I can tell you for a fact I haven't. Maybe I've deposed half. And by and large, they were a dishonest, deceitful, lying bunch of people.
Их преступные методы выставления счетов настолько распространены, что следователи страховых компаний называют их «калифорнийская отмашка» или «100-долларовое рукопожатие».
$100 handshake is when usually a patient is institutionalized. Psychiatrist, psychologist will visit that person, shake hands with them, say, hello, I'm doctor so-and-so, I'm taking care of your problem here, and then leaves.
They might have 10 or 20 patients there. They bill an hour for each one, and they might be in the hospital for a total of 30 minutes. So 20 patients, 20 hours. And they'd send the bills off to Medicaid.
We see that most of the victims of recovered memory therapy were women who had excellent health insurance, whether it was government insurance or private insurance, because many insurance policies wouldn't pay for this kind of long-term nonsense. So those people were targeted because of the nature of the insurance that they had.
Ежегодно психиатры США обворовывают правительство и частные страховые компании на $40 миллиардов, всячески обманывая общественность.
There were some advertisements, very seductive advertisements, for people wanting to lose weight and were having problems losing weight. And they would be given, you know, all expenses paid to go to a particular spa. But when they got to this spa and went in and signed in, it wasn't a spa, it was a psychiatric center. And then they couldn't get out.
What instead they received is they received massive doses of mind-altering drugs, and they were kept for a lengthy period of time, and their insurance carrier was billed tremendous amounts of money for something that was unnecessary.
Но их ложь выходит за пределы их клиник. Будучи платными свидетелями в судах, они говорят все, что угодно, чтобы получить свои деньги.
A psychiatric expert who will have one opinion in one scenario and a completely opposite opinion in another scenario based on which law firm or governmental agency is paying for his time.
The psychiatrist on one hand will tell the public that suicide can be prevented, but will go into court and tell a jury that suicide cannot be prevented. And then once you show his prior inconsistent statements, you also show that he is paid very well by pharmaceuticals, then the jury says, you know what, we're not so sure about you. Because you just lied to us.
Добавьте к их алчности и нечестности еще и сексуальные преступления. Хотя доля психиатров среди медиков в Америке составляет лишь 6%, они ответственны за треть сексуальных преступлений, совершаемых врачами.
It has happened so often that by the mid-80s, the insurance companies who insure physicians across America started writing sexual claims out of the policies altogether. That's how common it was.
The system was so broken that more than 25,000 complaints had been registered, but nothing acted upon. When a psychiatrist has a patient, a female patient, and abuses them sexually, there's a very high probability they'll get away with it.
I've seen many cases where the mental health professional becomes very disturbed and is using very strange and odd treatments, and that can go on for many years with no one finding out about it because it's not very public. It's quite private. Things happen behind closed doors.
Трагедия в том, что их сексуальные преступления часто затрагивают детей. Например, доктор Маркхэм Берри, на первый взгляд всеми уважаемый человек. Но правда всплыла, когда его арестовали по обвинению в растлении малолетних. Из его дома вывезли целый фургон детской порнографии, а последующее расследование подтвердило сексуальную связь с бывшими пациентами, мальчиками от 7 до 17 лет, которых он фотографировал и насиловал. Суд назвал это 50 годами разнузданных, никем не замеченных сексуальных выходок Берри в отношении детей. И это не уникальный случай. Это тщательно замаскированная сущность представителей данной профессии. В любом городе и в любой стране вы найдете психиатров, занимающихся развратом, изнасилованиями, убийствами и мошенничеством. И как вы увидите, весь авторитет психиатрии основан на величайшем обмане.